In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the Meraki MG, which is the latest addition to the Meraki family of devices. The MG is an LTE cellular gateway, and it comes in two different variants. The first is going to be the MG21, which has the internal antenna, which is the one I have here. It also comes in a variant called the MG21E, which comes with external antennas in case you needed that extra little bit of signal boost. So the plan for today's video is two things. First, we'll go ahead and burn through the box and see what we have in it. Next, we'll jump over to the Meraki dashboard and see what it takes to get this thing set up and connected to our network. So let's go ahead and get started. Once we open up the box, we'll be greeted with the MG21. This is a little bit of a smaller device than I had anticipated, though it is pretty hefty. Not too much to see on the front here. On the back, we have a little plate that's part of the mounting bracket, as well as we have this cover that protects our Ethernet ports, our power port, as well as our SIM card slot. Now you may notice this little rubber gasket here. This is to protect the device. It is IP67 rated when installed properly, and can be used in some of those slightly challenging environments should you have them. We also have the screws, instruction guide, and the mounting bracket in this device. Now, one thing to note is that if you did watch my video recently on the Netgear LTE modem, we did need an adapter for our SIM card. However, this device does take a straight nano SIM card, so we can go ahead and just pop this in without any adapter. So I'll go ahead and finish getting this all set up, and then we'll jump over to the Meraki dashboard and see what it takes to get this thing running. All right, now that we got the device all set up, I went ahead and plugged that directly into my PC for the moment. We're going to do some initial config before we get everything joined into the Meraki dashboard. So the first thing that we're going to do is open up a command prompt and check to make sure that we're connected. And we do have an IP address. Our IP is 192.168.5.51 and our gateway is 0.1. And that gateway should be the Meraki MG device. Alternatively, since we're already connected to the MG and we're getting an IP address from it, Meraki makes it easy on us, and we can just go to mg.meraki.com, and here's the local web interface for our Meraki MG. Now we can see a couple of things. Obviously, one, we see what our current client IP address and MAC address is. We can see some specs for the MG21. We can see different signals. We can also see that the carrier does show as Google Fi, but unfortunately the APN still shows tmobile.com, which is incorrect. Since I'm using Google Fi as a carrier, we're going to have to go ahead and change that to make sure that we can actually connect successfully. On top of that, we also see below that the cell gateway is not currently connected to the Cisco Meraki cloud. That's going to be two reasons. One, the LTE network isn't working yet because we haven't configured it. And two, the current LAN interface that I have is just connected straight to my PC, so there is no network connection out that direction. Let's go ahead and hit the Configure tab. And it's going to ask us for a username and password. Our username is going to be the device serial number. And we'll go ahead and sign in with no password. We have a couple of different options here that we can configure for the MG, but the one that we care about is cell override for APN. We'll go ahead and say override SIM settings. And for APN, we'll change this to H2G2 for Google Fi. Next, we'll go ahead and click save. And go back to the connection page. We'll refresh this once or twice while we wait for it to connect. After a couple of minutes, we can see on our connection page that we are connected at 4G with our carrier Google Fi and the APN that we had configured. We are getting an IP address from our cellular provider, and according to the MG, it is connected to the internet. Now it's having a little bit of trouble connecting to the Cisco Meraki cloud at the moment, but we'll go ahead and fix that later. For now, let's go ahead and hop back over to the dashboard and start getting this added to our network. So the first thing that we're going to have to do is go over to Organization, Inventory, so we can claim the device. Up in the upper right corner, we'll see Claim. And in here, we can add the device serial number or the order number in order to just import all of the serial numbers from that order. Let me just go ahead and do that now. And we'll go ahead and hit Claim. And it does now show that we have claimed our Meraki MG21 as part of our network. Next, we'll go ahead and double check that we have our license added as well. So we'll go over to Organization and License Info. When we went to claim the device, since we entered the order number rather than just the device serial number, it also imported our license info as well, so we can see that we are licensed for 1MG cellular device. All right, now that we've checked all of that, the next thing that we need to do is go ahead and add the MG to our existing network. Right now, I only have a single wireless access point, which is why you only see the wireless tab on the left side. So we'll go ahead and go up to network-wide, add devices, and we'll see our MG up here. Click on the checkbox and click add device. Now with any luck, we should see cellular gateway pop up on the left side once we refresh the page. Sure enough, there it is. Looks like the settings for this are going to be pretty simple. So let's go to monitor first and see if our cell gateway is even connected to the dashboard yet. It's still offline for the moment, but we can go ahead and pre-configure it now. Let's go up to cell gateway, settings. Checking out some of the settings for the Meraki MG, it looks like our options are going to be pretty simplistic. The only operational mode supported for the MG right now is routed mode, which means that the MG acts as a NAT device and will translate the public cellular provider IP address to anything that's hidden behind it. In my case, since I'm just plugging this straight into my external firewall and will be using it from there, I don't really care as much about these settings since my firewall is just going to consume whatever DHCP address is handed to it and use that as the upstream internet provider. But if we go ahead and click on this, it does look like we have the option of changing what our default DHCP pool is, as well as how big of a subnet we want carved out of that pool for client addresses. We'll go ahead and hit cancel for now, and it does look like it also auto-assigns the MG management IP, which I'm fine with. If we scroll down a little bit, looks like we have some options for DHCP. The default lease time is a day. We'll go ahead and up that to a week since I don't want much changes on my firewall. Default DNS servers is proxy to upstream. I'll go ahead and switch this to using Cisco Umbrella. Looks like we also have the option to do reserved IPs as well as fixed IP addresses. What I might do later is come back once I have the MAC address of my firewall and add this in here so that it just gets a static assignment and we don't have to worry about DHCP. And so since we saw that the device only operates in NAT mode today, we'll also see some settings for port forwarding. By default, the MG is going to block all inbound traffic sourced from outside the cellular network towards our internal network. And if we want to allow any type of traffic through to whatever devices we have on the LAN side of the MG, we'll have to add a port forwarding rule here to allow that traffic. One thing that I think is kind of nice to see is we do have the ability to do traffic shaping. So cell bandwidth we have set to unlimited right now, but if we wanted to preserve data costs or whatever else, we could throttle that down a little bit. Looks like we also have some connectivity tests. Right now it's doing an uplink test to 8.8.8.8, which is one of Google's DNS servers. I'm good with all of these settings, so we'll go ahead and click save. All right, now that we've configured all of our settings for the MG, let's go ahead and go back to the actual local management page and see if it's connected yet. Sure enough, it looks like the cell gateway just needed a little bit of time to work out its connectivity to the Cisco Meraki cloud. You do see on the left side that it says the cell gateway is healthy. On the right side, you do see that the cell gateway details show the network name of the network that I have configured in the dashboard. So we should be pretty confident that it's already checked in and has pulled its configuration. One other thing I'd like to do right here is that we can run a speed test, see what kind of performance we're getting out of this thing so far. Let's go ahead and hit run. About 130, 140. Oh, up to about 150 meg of throughput. We'll go ahead and hit stop. It's a bit better performance than I was expecting out of this thing, which is kind of exciting. Next, let's go ahead and go back over to the Meraki dashboard and look at what monitoring statistics we might be getting out of this. We'll go over to cell gateway, monitor cell gateways, and we do see that our gateway is online, so let's go ahead and click on it. So this MG status page is going to give us a little bit of detail about what's going on with the device right now. First thing we see, we have two ports on the device. Our port one is up and active, which is what we'd expect. That's the one that is directly connected into my computer right now. The visualization we have here for connectivity under historical data, we have this set for the last 2 hours, and this is just going to show us whether or not the MG has been connected to the Meraki dashboard. So we do see a large period of inactivity before we configured it, then we see some offline point after we had configured the Meraki dashboard, and then finally the cell gateway did come online. Network usage is pretty low at the moment, which is to be expected. On the left side, we're going to see currently just the MAC address of the cell gateway itself. I can go ahead and configure the name for it. So we'll go ahead and set this to home cell gateway. We don't have a location set yet, but we'll go ahead and change that later. We can also see on the left side a couple of quick statistics around public IP, what our signal is, our IMEI and serial number, and it looks like our firmware is up to date, so that's all good. Now, if we wanted to look at some real good data on what the MG has to offer, let's go ahead and switch over to the uplink tab. This is going to show us a little bit better detail about what we're seeing. So we'll still see some information around, okay, here's our public IP. Our WAN is connected currently at IPv4 only. Our cell status is active, shows the IP gateway and DNS that we're receiving from the provider. We do show here that we are connected at 4G. Our signal strength is currently shown as okay. Looks like 2 out of 5 possible bars of signal. I will be interested to see what the signal shows and what kind of download speeds we get once the MG is in its permanent resting place, which is not in my basement where it's at now and up near a window instead. Again, we do see that we are connected to Google Fi, and now down to the fun stuff below. For some live data, we can see what our current uplink is out the cellular network or out the WAN port. There's not a whole lot going on, which is to be expected. Down below, we see the graphs just barely starting to populate for 4G data, as well as our connectivity out to 8.8.8.8, which again is just validating that we have internet traffic out the cellular gateway. Once we're done here, we can go ahead and check the DHCP tab. Currently, this isn't going to show a whole lot because we're going to have the subnet that we just configured in the Meraki dashboard, and one client, which is my current PC that's plugged into the device. Even once I get this all up and running, I'm only going to end up having one client, which is going to be my external firewall, and that's going to handle sending the traffic up to the MG for internet access. As with all the other Meraki devices, we're going to have the Tools tab, which will give us a set of utilities that we can use for troubleshooting. If we need to run any tests from the perspective of the device itself, we can run a ping, a traceroute, a DNS lookup, or even just click in here to go ahead and reboot the device. Alright, well that about covers everything that we can do with the MG today. Looks like the setup and the settings are pretty straightforward and simplistic. Since the device is still relatively new out of Meraki, I'll be interested to see what new firmware updates and developments come out in the near future, seeing if there's any additional settings or visualizations, graph data, whatever, that we end up getting for this platform. So for the time being, I'm just going to go ahead and get this device connected to my firewall, all set up, and start using it. That's all I had for this video. Thanks for watching.